come on and raise your cup. If we talk about memories, yeah, we're gonna make them. Talk about rules, you know we're gonna break them. When the lights come on, everybody's screaming, lighters in the sky, yeah, everybody's singing. Every word to every song to the girl that's hanging tonight. When the lights come on, everybody's feeling a hallelujah. From the floor to the ceiling, yeah, the drink that we're there, the smoke that we're there, the party we're through, it's going all night long. When the lights come on, when the lights come on. Yeah, we all the same, cause we thinking the same thing. We on the same page, cause we sipping the same drink. Here's a little something to thank y'all for showing up. Al Dean and the boys are about to blow it up. When the lights come on, everybody's screaming, lighters in the sky, yeah, everybody's singing. Every word to every song to the girl that's hanging tonight. When the lights come on, everybody's feeling a hallelujah. From the floor to the ceiling, yeah, the drink that we're there, the smoke that we're there, the party we're through, it's going all night long. When the lights come on, when the lights come on.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Super Bowl dreams are on the line today in the conference championship, where only one team can move on. It's the Cardinals going up against the Falcons. On the call here tonight, let's send it out to our guys in the booth. That's Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Well, there's a new building set to open adjacent to us to the south, but for now, they're still playing football at the Georgia Dome, and that's where we're located here in downtown Atlanta. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl, and we've got a classic in store between the Arizona Cardinals and the Atlanta Falcons. The 30 to the 31-yard line. A gain of three, second down. And here's a look at the starting offense. See if they stay on the ground for second down. They'll need to get the play off quickly. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's got his man on the crossing route. They were ready for what the defense was showing. They had prepared for that look, recognized it, went straight to the air, got the first. Well done.
Love the recognition, because you can prepare for everything. You can watch the tape and put together your game plan, but you still have to understand what they're doing in terms of what they're showing and be able to adjust accordingly, and they did exactly that.
They go play action here on first down. Wide open receiver complete. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. And a nice little pass and catch there on the corner route.
Set up very well by the receiver with a head and shoulder fake inside before he comes back downhill to his quarterback.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. They'll set up a throw. And he rifles one incomplete. And it's possible that today the most important group could be the linebackers.
Yeah, the second level, as we like to call them, right? Defensive front has to control things, but the linebackers, they do more than clean up. They help create big plays.
Second down now after the incompletion. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Oh, 10 yards to go on third. To throw again. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23.
The goal of every offense is to move the chains, pick up first downs. A nice job finding an open receiver for a completion.
So the offense has it first and 10. The play clock's running down, and they'll go with a ground attack here. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
I believe I understand where the offense was going there. They just hit a big pass play, thought they could fool him with a run, but maybe they overthought it a little bit. Just hit a nice pass, come back with another one, keep the momentum going.
Play clock winding down. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up.
Green 39! Green 39! Detroit! Detroit! 3-19! 3-19!
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Deep drop. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Their big-bodied receiver, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Cardinals take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. All week in practice, they stretched, grounding, pounding the football, and they really executed it well there to get the first down.
That usually means getting back to being physical in practice, because when you emphasize pounding the football, it doesn't really come together unless you practice it the same way you're going to play it in the game. That means more bodies, more pads, and a whole lot of popping last week, and they got it done in the game.
And he finds a man on the crossing route. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. He'll look to throw. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. And here's the offense today that hopes to get off to a strong start. Second down now after the pass completion. Give it to him right up the gut. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy. Let him pick up the first down.
On the give, this is their fullback. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And the linebacking core could certainly be crucial today.
They do everything really, really well. Fly to the football, defend the pass, you name it, they do it, as well as set the defensive front.
To throw here. Over the middle, it's complete. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential, but when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
Detroit! Detroit! Leppard! Leppard! Let's go!
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big time drop.
Here comes the 8th play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down.
Let's go!
Again, he'll drop to throw. And the third down pass falls incomplete. So out now comes the field goal unit for the Falcons. This will be a 37-yard attempt. And his kick is indeed good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Big mistake here by the kicker, kicking it out of bounds.
The one that drives coaches crazy. Keep it in the field of play and let your guys cover.
And the D looking like they may blitz. Now a play fake here on first down. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. It's a gain of 5, and it'll bring up a second down.
Now, that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. And he floats one there, incomplete. Third down and five.
Tight, watch left.
Time running out here on the play clock.
Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down. Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gauden. Here comes the Cardinals punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal, and I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out now joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
Yeah, maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. That throw good for four. It's second down. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll push forward for about four up to the 23.
Everyone's looking for the big runs, the explosive runs, the 20 to 30-yard plays. But anytime you're picking up good yardage and setting yourself up on down and distance, offenses love that too.
Play fake. He'll look to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. A great read. And they will score. It's a pick six for the Cardinals touchdown. Well, he tried to get rid of it. Pressure was coming right in his face, and it turned out to be a bad thing.
And it's so easy to be critical of him in that spot. When you have all those people bearing down on you, probably his last thought was just get rid of the ball. Give them what they want. Unfortunately, he gave it to them too well. Picked it off, ran it back for a touchdown.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And last year, that would have been a net gain of five on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They'll come out in the pistol. We'll see the pistol here. And on the ground they go with a running back. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Second down following the run. Another pistol look here. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he'll bring it back to the 9-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
They go play action here on first down. That is caught at the 7-yard line. Call it a gain of 3, and that'll make it second and goal.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
They come out here in the eye. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Back to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Squander this great field position. Here's third and goal. Defense showing blitz. They'll give it to him right up the gut. 6 yards puts him right on the doorstep, but now it'll be fourth and goal.
This drive started with first and goal. Now that it's fourth and goal, anything less than a touchdown would feel like a letdown to me.
No move to take the offense on the field. They're going to stay out there and go for it on fourth and goal. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. They'll try and sneak it here. They try the sneak, but not enough push. He doesn't get in. And the Falcons able to muster together a goal line stand. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping him for a minimal gain.
So second and medium, second and 5 now. From deep in their own territory, they look to throw toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. Third down, a nickel formation here defensively. He'll look to throw. He's got his man on the crossing route. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball.
everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Super Bowl dreams are on the line today, and the conference championship, where only one team can move on. It's the Cardinals going up against the Falcons. With kickoff straight ahead, let's check in with the two men who'll be calling tonight's game. So we say hello to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. You are looking live at the Georgia Dome here in downtown Atlanta. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl. And we've got a classic in store between the Arizona Cardinals and the Atlanta Falcons. They'll come out in the pistol.
All right, here we go. Boom, landing. Leppard.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. And he's not going anywhere to start the night. They stop him at the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. And when this offense is clicking on all cylinders, the running back is in sync as well.
The focal point. Runs, catches, blocks, sets the tone for the offense.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. Evades the tackler and now some space. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. And they talked about how important the passing game was going to be against that defensive look. Good job there going to the air for the first down.
It's all about preparation. It's all about planning. And then it's about execution. So they put it all together in practice. Okay, this is what we think we're going to see. This is how they get to it. And then when the game comes, read it and attack it.
And now a first down following that long gain. The play clock's running down. They'll look to throw. Looking left sideline, incomplete. And this defensive line will be looking to control the point of attack.
And that's what they've done throughout this season. This is a terrific unit. They play together very, very well, and they don't permit big plays to happen.
Comes the D swarming to the line. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And a quick throw here, that's complete. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Partner, nothing complicated here. This is just a pretty simple drag route.
You're exactly right, Brandon. Instead of throwing it downfield, they just throw it underneath and let the receiver do the work.
Go. and 3 full yards here for the offense to get on third down. Throw again. And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down. And now out is the Cardinal field goal team here. From the right hash and call it an even 50 yards. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And the Cardinals have the first points. It's 3-0. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. Sheds a second man.
He's building up some momentum, isn't he?
And not great starting field position here for the offense.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19.
They'll bring a receiver in motion left. And they'll go on the ground. Oh, look at the juke. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And how about this wide receiving core, Charles?
Well, I was at the hotel watching a little film, and you popped your head in and said, these receivers are pretty good from what I can tell. You're exactly right. Can't wait to see them do their thing out on the field.
Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Second and 5. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Now, that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handling a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. And the big meat on the D-line, we'll see how they do today.
And I'd hate to be an offensive lineman having to deal with these guys. They come in hungry, mean, and confident. They think that no one can block them.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what's... My second body cost a lot.